Hello everyone. Thanks a lot for viewing the session. I'm Aditi Gangwar. I work as a product manager for PDF in Microsoft Edge, and it's great to have you here. So today we'll be talking about how the PDF reader in Microsoft Edge really meets the needs of your enterprise, and it's an enterprise-grade PDF reader. So a lot of us view PDF files very regularly, like on a weekly basis, if not on a daily basis. PDF files may come in different formats for different people. For example, for sales and legal teams, they usually come as agreements and contracts. For other people in your organization, it might be research papers or standards documents. And I think all of us know that, you know, about the tax forms and the bills and invoices that we view regularly. So given that it's such an important file format, we really need a PDF reader which actually suits the need of everyone in your organization. So based on the feedback that we have had from you over the last 2 years, we have tried to add a lot of features in PDF Reader which would help the needs of your organization. We've added things like inking, adding, viewing and validating digital signatures, MIP files, highlight mode, and so on and so forth. And everything, it comes with the promise of security and reliability of Microsoft. It's really secure and it's really, really reliable. And all of it can be managed with a really, really low TCO since it's built in right into the browser. It's there in the browser, you manage it as you manage the rest of the browser, and it's available across platforms. It's available on Windows, it's available on macOS, and very soon it'll be available on Linux as well. So let's jump quickly into the rich feature set. So when we reached out to you for feedback, a lot of the feedback we got from you was that nearly 95% of people in your organization view PDF files for basic reading and navigation capabilities. So that was the first thing we wanted to address. We wanted to ensure that reading PDF files and navigating through them was as smooth as possible. We invested a lot on making sure that the scroll is really smooth and it brings in a sense of calm while reading PDF files. In addition to it, we've also added a new feature called Table of Contents, which is if there's a PDF file which does come with a table of contents, you would see them right there in the browser itself. You can navigate to different sections of the file using the table itself. This really eases the whole PDF reading experience. And for those people in your organization who need more features, we do have a set of features like inking, highlight, read aloud, form fill that people can use. Last Ignite, we did have support for inking. We have added support for inking in different colors and with different stroke widths. This is really useful in certain conditions, like if you want to quickly sign a document and do not want to attach the whole legalities of adding a certificate to it, you can just take up a pen and ink the PDF file right there in the browser. You don't need to go anywhere else for it. You don't need to scan it, print it, and then scan it again. Coming to highlight mode is also a really interesting feature. Like, remember the pen and paper days when we used to just read a document or a book, we used to pick up a highlighter and highlight whatever we used to find interesting. What highlight mode does is that it enables you to do the same thing for an online file. While reading through a PDF file, you can just click on the highlight button. It'll enable highlight mode for you, and then you can just go on highlighting whatever you find interesting. You can just focus on the document itself, and you do not need to go and muddle with different tools while you're reading it. As always, you can fill in forms with PDF files. If there are any PDF forms that are there, you can fill them up right in the browser. You do not need to go anywhere else. And read aloud is something really interesting that we have recently added. In today's world, when most of us, if not all, need to do multitask quite a bit, read aloud comes in really handy. You can just click on it, choose the speed of the reading you want, choose a voice that you would like to hear, and then the PDF document would be read out to you. And you can parallelly do other tasks as well. And this is also really useful for enterprises who work with the education sector, and because read aloud is a really, really big ask from schools as well. And everything we talked about comes with support for accessibility, be it tabbing through PDF documents using a keyboard, be it navigating through PDF documents and then taking action on it using screen readers, or be it viewing the PDF documents in high contrast mode. All of them are enabled in the browser itself. In addition to these features, we do have some enterprise specific features as well. You can now view MIP and IRM protected files inside the PDF reader itself. You do not need to get another software. You do not need to manage another add-in. You can just, as long as you're signed into the browser, you can view those files right in the browser. Basically, for those of us who are new to MIP, what MIP is basically Microsoft Information Protection. What it does is that only the people who have access to a certain file are able to access it and view or take those actions that they have permissions to. For example, I can only view an annotator file if I've been explicitly granted permissions for it. Big example of its usage would be, suppose I go to a party to a friend's place and I get an import mail, I download a PDF file, I go through it. It might just happen that I forget deleting it from the user's file. But as long as I've remembered to sign out from the browser, no one else can actually view the file on my friend's computer. They need to have their explicit permissions for it. It really helps safeguard the data of your organization and keep it secure. And coming to a really interesting feature, which is digital signatures. Almost every enterprise that we've talked to till today has this very strong ask, which is to add capability to add digital signatures onto PDF document itself. And these are certificate-based digital signatures, which do have legal validity as well. We're currently adding the support for it in three stages. The first stage, which is view and validate digital signature, allows you to view the signature, see whether it's valid based on different conditions, right there in the browser. Again, no add-in required, no licensing required. You can just view if there's a PDF file which does have a signature, you can view it right there in the browser. We'll be talking a bit more about it in a demo very soon. We're currently doing a preview for it. So in case your organization does use digital signatures, please do let us know and we'd be happy to get feedback from you about it. Once the stage is done, we would then be focusing on stage two, which is preserving digital signatures if you annotate on a file, provided the signature allows for it. That is, if the signature says that the other users can annotate on a PDF file or fill a PDF file without invalidating the signature, you will be able to go ahead and then do those annotations on it. And over the course of next year, we're planning to add the capability of adding digital signatures as well, right there in the browser. Moving on, let's jump into a quick demo and see how these features work. Boom. Now suppose I'm a vendor who's organizing an event at Contoso Private Limited. They sent me this file to have a look at, and it also has some other legal content in it, which I need to send to my legal team for review. So let me quickly start. I'll just fill in my name and I'll put in my address. And let's see if there is something else important here. Okay, 15%. So let me just highlight this so that my colleagues also notice this and let me know what their thoughts about it are. Must comply with regulation and have the required permits. I'm not sure if we do have the permits for it. So let me just send out a message to my legal team to check. And we're good. The rest of it looks fine as well. I'll just add my signature here at the bottom. Change the color and the thickness and we should be good. Ideally, this should have been a form field, but since it isn't, I'll just add in my date using a pen. So we are good with this. I'll now go ahead and send out to my legal team. I can just go to settings and more, click on share. This will give me some save targets. See who I can share it with. And done. All I need to click on is send, and the file will be sent to the legal team for their review. Now this is perfect. Now when my legal team actually gets the file, what they would be able to do is to simply go to the table of contents, go to the part that they are interested in, which maybe say payment terms, which they might want to review first, or maybe the privacy statement. They can have their review and then send the file back to me. So this is great. Now, in addition to all this, if suppose I had added a digital signature, that is a certificate-based digital signature instead of a pen-based signature here, what the legal team would have seen is this. They would have seen a banner at the top which says that the document is digitally signed, and if clicking on view signatures, they can open the flyout here. Here it says that the signature is valid, the identity is valid, and the document has not been modified. So this is good. Had there been more signatures on the document, they would have shown up here as well. Click on properties actually takes me to the properties dialog, which has further details if needed. So here, they would have been able to view and validate the signature, see whether the document has been modified or not, right here in the browser itself. They would not have needed to go out of the browser context.
Coming back from the demo, let's quickly talk about Microsoft Information Protection as well.
we did talk about it earlier, where if the users have permissions to do certain actions and to view a particular file, only then would they be able to view the file. So if you're logged into the browser and you have permissions to view a file, you would see a new banner at the top of the file saying that the document is protected. If you click on view signatures, you would see what permissions you have on a particular file. Again, all this is done right there in the browser without the need of anything else. Moving on, let's quickly see a video about what's coming. So what we just saw were the upcoming capabilities, which are being able to add and edit text notes in the PDF files, viewing the files in custom layouts, like two-page layouts or custom scrolling, and then viewing the labels of MIP-protected files. The additional things that are coming in by the end of the calendar year are being able to add image-based signatures to PDF file. So for example, if you have a signature in an image, you can just add it easily to a PDF file and get done with it. We're also adding the capability to view MIP-protected files in other tenants. For example, if your organization acquires another organization, then both of them might actually be in two different tenants. Very soon, you'd be able to view the files which might be protected in other tenants or other organizations as well. We're also increasing and broadening the support that we have for viewing and validating certificate-based digital signatures. And in addition to these, we are adding support for filling forms using screen readers like NVDA or Narrator. And we're also adding support for navigating through PDF files using Keyboard Carrot. A bit further ahead in our roadmap over the course of next year, we would be adding support for adding digital signatures in the PDF file itself inside the browser, adding MIP labels to PDF file, that is protecting PDF files right there in the browser, previewing PDF files in File Explorer and Outlook. Once this is done, it will be a really seamless end-to-end flow where users would be able to view PDF files right there in Outlook itself without the need for any other software. And we would also be adding support for improving experience for screen readers by supporting Tagtree. Tagtree basically helps establish landmarks inside a PDF document, and screen readers can leverage those tags to actually navigate through the PDF document. Having talked about the features that we have, as we said, we come with the security and reliability of Microsoft. One of the biggest reasons for using it was the reliability that it comes with. It has been used to open billions of PDF files across platforms, Windows, Mac, and Linux as well. So it's really, really reliable. And coming to security, every PDF file that opens from a particular source opens in its own separate process of its own, which means that the different PDF files from different sources don't really talk to each other. They don't talk to the web pages that might be opened separately. This keeps your data really, really secure. And in addition to it, we do support Application Guard as well. That is, if Application Guard for Windows 10 is configured, then depending on the setting, any PDF file that is opened will open in the App Guard container. When downloaded, it would be downloaded into the container itself. And when a user tries to reopen it, it would again happen in the container. This ensures that any content that your organization might find malicious stays inside that container and is away from your network and the system of the user. It again helps keep your organization data really secure. And having talked about the features and how we come with enterprise-grade compliance, let's quickly see as to how you can manage and deploy it. You can definitely decrease your TCO by adopting Edge as the PDF reader, because it's one less app for you to manage. There's no licensing costs involved. You do not need to manage the installation and updates and add-ins for different softwares. it's built in right into the browser. Also, since it's built into the browser, you can manage it as you manage the browser itself. You don't really need to take more actions for it. It's available across platforms. It's a single software that works for Windows, macOS, and Linux. The support for Linux is coming really soon. And you can manage it using group policies using the centralized management software of your choice, be it Intune, be it Jamf, be it Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Whichever software you use, you can manage the policies. In addition, if you'd want some additional policies for PDF, please do let us know and we'd be happy to take those in as well. In order to help you deploy, here are some of the programs that we have running. We have App Assure, which basically says that if there's anything, any site or PDF that worked on IE11 or Chrome or the older Microsoft Edge, we'll work with you to make sure that it works in the new Microsoft Edge as well at no additional cost. Also, if you have more than 150 plus Windows 10 Enterprise seats and are a member of FastTrack, you can use a FastTrack program to help you deploy Edge and hence your PDF reader as well. And if you do have a unified support contract, you can leverage that contract to have your queries about PDF answered as well. Hence, why should any organization make Edge the default PDF reader? We have some really great features like inking, digital signatures, MIP, which really help keep an organization data really safe and secure while providing the end users the power that they need. It comes with enterprise-grade security and reliability, and it's really, really, really easy to manage at zero licensing costs. Thank you so much for listening to the video. We really hope to connect with you further. Please feel free to send us a mail at adigan@microsoft.com for any suggestions or queries that you may have. And you can definitely find some great documentation at ak.ms/deploy-edge-pdf. Thank you and have a great day.